Hello everyone and welcome back on Art Explainerception. I'm here for the fourth and very last video of this series that we really enjoyed making. So what will this video be about? Well, we are going to talk about a specific case study of a channel called Art Contemporain with which we are going to make a conclusion on what we have seen in the other videos and then conclude and see a bit what can be done to further improve the popularization of art on YouTube. So first of all, I'm going to talk about Art Contemporain, which is a French girl who popularized contemporary arts especially, and she has around 40,000 subscribers, which is quite a good number compared to the other popularization channels. We tried to like focus on what were the most viewed video on this channel, why they would work, what was the trend of our channel. So what we have witnessed is that the video that works the most is her first video, which is called Introduction à l'histoire de l'art. So Introduction to History of Art. So it's quite a general topic. It's an introduction, it's something you can find easily if you, for example, have an exam needed for educational purposes or just want an introduction to the field. So this goes back on what was saying Marilou in the last video, I hope you have seen it, when she was saying that it is more general titles that work the most. We really witnessed this here as well. But otherwise, her videos tend to be around 10,000 views. So before, she would have more views, like 20,000 views, but it tend to decrease. So we were wondering why, and what we have witnessed is that the topics of the videos tend to be less general but more specific. For example, she has released new formats such as breaking news or some vlogs. So it's less about very specific things in the study of art, but it's still related to art but in another way, so maybe people are less tend to find it easily. But they would find it if, for example, they are already subscribing to the channel, which is great, what she still has some views. We also have seen that she was trying to have more punchy titles. Something that would like catch the eye. So for example, she says l'œuvre de Banksy s'autodétruit with three question marks, like to very make it seem like it's very a huge issue. In the same level, she says je parle sorcière et féminisme non-stop pendant 8 minutes 45, like in capital letters, as if it was something like a huge thing. She could have titled it sorcière et féminisme dans l'art. It would have worked as well, like witches and feminism in art, but she didn't show, so she really uses YouTube's codes of other channels that are working a lot. And one video is quite interesting, it's the one that is titled Antoine Daniel ne vous a pas tout dit. So this one is really nice because she actually analyzes the videos of a channel that is very known in France, which is What the Cut, and so she analyzes all the references to art he's doing in his videos, because most of the time he's trying to speak negatively about what's displayed in this video, because this art is supposed to be what the cut, what the fuck. And it's actually one of the videos that have worked the best on her channel, so it's really interesting. We see that by drawing on popular references and pop culture, she makes popularization something nice, something that's going to be seen, because there has been this whole thing around Antoine Daniel. So in a way she's kind of using it, but it's for the good goes. And on this idea of using pop culture to explain art, well, she used the TV show Euphoria, which was released this summer, and it really was a great success. And what she does is that she focuses on the pieces of art that are showed in the show, and she makes a bit of like background on the piece, like what is it here, what does it tell about his life, art, etc. So it's not one of the videos that worked the best for her, but it's interesting to see that she tries to implement this strategy that Marilou talked about in the last video. She also uses what's working at the moment, so some topics that we are hearing about a lot because people are more able to speak about it. So for example, the awareness about homosexuality. She has done two videos about homosexuality within art, but also about witches, feminism and witches, as I spoke earlier. So it's really a trendy topic, so it's like she uses it. Same for the news, such as Banksy, she's using that. So we have seen the evolution of the channel through her videos and the titles, and I'm going now to focus more on the techniques she uses. How does she talk, and what techniques does she use to popularize art within her language? So she uses a very non-technical, affordable language without being too familiar, but she speaks slowly and distinctly, and she uses a lot of young expressions, like young situations that young people would know, these non-references to pop culture. She also has it in the language. She also uses many examples, so you always have something like popping on the screen. There's a lot of rhythm in the video, you cannot be bored. You draw on the example of Marilou about jokes. She makes jokes. Once she refers to Bourdieu, and it's in the video about witches, so she says Bourdieu or Bourdiable, which is a pun with the evil. So as we have seen in the last video, she introduces a concept, then breaks it with a joke. So the aim of this video was to apply the techniques that Marilou has developed in the last video to a specific case study about Afro-Continent, so I hope it was really clear. And now I would like to speak about something new, because I would like to question the future of popularization on YouTube. What does work to popularize art? How can we reinvent it? What is the future of this? So a new path could be the collaboration between YouTubers and museums and institutions. As we have seen in the second video, museums and institutions are less at ease with popularization. Either the content is not viewed that much, or their videos are addressed to people that already know about the field. So as to boost their channels on these subjects, we have witnessed that they tend to associate with YouTubers who are maybe more used to creating YouTube content, since it is what they do, so they know. I'm going to take the example of the Louvre Museum, so a really renowned museum, which has around 40,000 subscribers on YouTube and around 10,000 views per video, so quite the same as the channel that we have previously seen. Within the top 11 videos on this channel, 5 were created in partnership with famous YouTubers who popularized many subjects. So we had Cyrus North, Le Fossoyeur de Film, Nota Bene, Axolot and Dirty Biology. At least 6 other YouTubers have their videos on the channel, but they were not as viewed as these ones. But research really see that this collaboration works, and that maybe a future for the popularization of arts on YouTube. And we actually contacted a YouTube channel called Le Moc, which popularizes literature. So they are working on a partnership with Le Louvre, like one of those I've just listed, et answer that il s'agit à la fois de faire vibrer la corde intellectuelle et la corde émotive du spectateur, which means that they have to touch the public both intellectually and emotionally. So this is very interesting, because it shows that popularization works only if it's not only about the mind, but also about emotions, not only rational, but also irrational. And it proves well what we have seen through our previous videos, because there are some tricks that are needed to make arts something enjoyable and something that you want to hear about and to interest people in arts. So this video aims at providing you with a specific case study and showing you the future, the possible future of popularization with institutions and YouTubers working together. But all the questions we asked ourselves were, for example, does the arts popularization really work at reaching a broader public? And if so, what's its impact? And how to make arts accessible to more people and to overcome the cultural inequalities that were described by Bourdieu, as we have seen in the first video. So we do not have the answers to this question, unfortunately, but no one really has the answer to them, and what's good is to reflect upon them. So this series is coming to an end. We hope that you really enjoyed watching them as much as we enjoyed making them, and we plan on being back on our channel soon, and we hope that you'll be there to see our next series. Until then, don't forget to subscribe and to put a like if you enjoyed the content. See you!